Dear students, today I will tell the story of circulatory system of our body. You know, our heart is a muscular organ which can generate impulse continuously and automatically. Now see the interior part of heart. The two sides of heart is divided by a septum to avoid the mixing of deoxygenated and oxygenated blood. And each side is further divided into atrium and ventricle. There are valves in between the atrium and ventricle to prevent the backflow of blood from ventricle to atrium. Now let us see how does it work. The deoxygenated blood from all over the body comes into the right atrium via superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. In this time, atrium is relaxed, but when get totally filled, it starts to contract and opens the tricuspid valve and transfers the blood to the right ventricle. This time right ventricle is relaxed, but again when get totally filled, it closes the tricuspid valve and pumps the blood to the pulmonary artery. Now you know that this is the deoxygenated blood, so it needs to getting purified. Hence it comes to the lung where gaseous exchange occur. So in the nearby capillary, CO2 goes to the alveoli and oxygen comes to the capillary artery. Now it is required to spread all over the body. So this oxygenated blood comes to the left atrium via pulmonary vein. Two pulmonary veins from each lung. Left atrium now relax and getting filled with oxygenated blood. When get filled totally, it starts to contract, opens the mitral valve and transfer the oxygenated blood to the left ventricle. In this time ventricle is relaxed and getting fulfilled, closes the mitral valve and pump the blood to the aorta. Aorta takes a bend behind the heart and over the pulmonary artery. During bending, it gives some branches to our upper portion of our body and goes downward to supply the lower portion of our body. This blood goes to all tissues of our body where again gaseous exchange occurs and tissue use this oxygen to compensate the requirement of ATP, that is energy, and simultaneously carbon dioxide is produced, goes to the capillary vein. So this blood is again get deoxygenated and again goes to the superior via superior vena cava to the right atrium and via inferior vena cava also to the right atrium. Clearly here two circulation is noticed. One is from heart to lung, that is pulmonary circulation, and another is from heart to tissue, that is systemic circulation. So it is called the double circulation. Okay, and another point is